Biology.
So welcome there. Now allow us to look at Kingdom Protoctista. So for the Kingdom Protoctista, we see that they mainly include algae and the protozoa. So what are the general characteristics of the organisms under the Kingdom Protoctista? So the first one, we see that they are eukaryotic cells. So all their organelles are membrane bound, hence the name eukaryota. So the other name of Kingdom Protoctista is Kingdom Protista or eukaryota cells, meaning that their organelles are membrane bound. So they are also unicellular and some of them are multicellular. So the nutrition for this organism is basically autotrophic or heterotrophic mode of nutrition. They mainly move by pseudopodia, cilia and flagella. Some of them are, however, sessile, meaning that they cannot move. So they reproduce asexually by either fission, fragmentation, or sporulation process. So let's look at the first organism under this kingdom, which is now a single cell algae referred to as the Chlamydomonas. As you can see, this is the Chlamydomonas. Now for this Chlamydomonas, you see that they are plant-like protoctista. They contain chlorophyll and they are autotrophic, meaning that they make their own food from the surrounding light trees in the environment. So some of them have a thyroid body plants, which is simply flattened with many cells not differentiated. So they inhabit mainly aquatic environment. Examples, we have the pond, we have the lakes, the seas, etc. So as you can see in the diagram of the Chlamydomonas, you can see it possesses double flagella. It possesses also a very small vacuole and a very large cytoplasm. So it also has a very large chloroplast, meaning that it makes its own food. So this proves that it is definitely autotrophic. So it also has a central nucleus and it also possesses a cell wall. Now inside the cytoplasm, you will also notice it contains starch grain. Apart from the starch grain, it has these structures which are referred to as the pyrenoids. So what are the functions of these pyrenoids? So the function of these pyrenoids is that they trap carbon dioxide for the dark stage of photosynthesis to manufacture now the starch. Now let's look at the next type of algae in Kingdom Protoctista, which is the filamentous algae referred to as Spirogyra. Now the Spirogyra is the most common type of algae known to man. It is filamentous, meaning that it is made up of very many cells. So if you have been asked in an exam why is it filamentous, explain why it is filamentous, you will say that it is filamentous, meaning that it is made up of very many cells. So each cell has a large nucleus whereby the cell is bound by a rigid cell wall made up of cellulose. So the cell wall is basically covered by the mucilage. And as you can see also in the diagram, you can see that there is the cytoplasm, there is the cell wall, there is the central nucleus, there is the spiral chloroplast, and also the main thing is that it has the pyrenoids. Whereby you say that the function of the pyrenoids is that they trap the carbon dioxide molecule for the process of photosynthesis in the dark stage. So, what are now the significance of algae? How are the algae important? So the first one, we see that the diatomite is a product of algae diatoms. So it originates from the algae diatoms. So they are also source of food, the main source of food or the primary source of food for the fish living in aquatic environment. So they also assist in lab culture preparation to grow different bacteria and fungi for the testing of different pathogens in these organisms, or testing of different characteristics in these organisms that have been grown. So they are also used as bait for fishermen, whereby they can be purchased commercially for the sale. And also we see that the lichen helps in soil formation by algae and the fungi. They are also used as food and medicine, as well as they cause different types of diseases, especially this one which is called dermatitis, as you can see. So they are also used as organic fertilizers, whereby we know that the function of fertilizer is to restore the soil fertility. And also they are used in sewage treatments as they extract the inorganic toxins and nutrients from the dirty water that is being treated. Now, far from that, let's now look at the protozoa. So for the protozoa, we see that they are animal-like productista. For the algae, we saw that they are plant-like productista. Now for the protozoa, these are animal-like productista. They are also microscopic and unicellular, and they are also heterotrophic except a few like the euglena, which is mainly autotrophic. So the main locomotory structure is by pseudopodia, cilia, and flagella. They also reproduce asexually, as we had seen for the algae. So the protozoa is divided into several phyla, whereby the first phyla in protozoa is phyla Rhizopoda, then the next one is phyla Ciliophora or Ciliata, then the next one is Masticophora or Flagellata. So Flagellata meaning that they use flagella for movement. Ciliata, the previous one, means that they use cilia for movement. And then finally, the last one is Sporozoa or the Apicomplexa. Now let's meet on the next session as we look more and discuss more on the phylum Rhizopoda. Biology.